namo bhagavate vasudevaya. Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya. Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya. Narayanam namaskritya naram chaiva narottamam devim saraswati vyasa tato jaya mudiraye nashta prayesu abhadresu nityam bhagavata sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Sloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtike Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devaki Nandanaya Cha Nanda Gopa Kumaraya Govindaya Namo Namaha Nilachala Nivasaya Nityaya Paramatmane Balabhadra Subhadravya Jagannathaya Te Namaha Om Ajnanati Mirandasya Jnananjana Salakaya Chaksuran militam yena tasmai shri gurave namaha Shri chaitanya manovishtam tapitam yena bhutale Swayang rupa kadamaiham dadati swapadantikam Vandeham shri guru shri yuta padakamalam shri gurun vaishnavangsha Shri rupam sagrajatam sahagana raghunathanitam tam sajivam Sadvaitam Sabadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padan Sagana Lalita Sri Visakhanitam Cha Namom Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Sri Mate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Paschatade Satarine Banchakalpataru Vyascha Krupa Sindhu Vyayevacha Patitanang Pavane Vyo Vaishnave Vyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. So welcome all the assembled devotees to our regular Bhagavatam class. This morning we are reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 8, Chapter 22, entitled Bali Maharaj surrenders his life. Text 26. Janma karma bayo rupa vidva vidya aishwarya dhana divi yadyasya na bhavet stambhas Tatrayam madanugraha Janma by birth in an aristocratic family. Karma by wonderful activities, pious activities. Vaya by age, especially youth. When one is capable of doing many things. Rupa by personal beauty which attracts everyone. Vidya by education. Aishwarya by opulence. Dhana by wealth. Adibhi by other opulences. Yadi, if asya of the possessor, na, not, bhavet, there is, stambha, pride, tatra, in such a condition, I am a person, madanugraha, should be considered to have received my special mercy. Translation and purport by Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Translation. If a human being is born in an aristocratic family or a higher status of life, if he performs wonderful activities, if he is youthful, if he has personal beauty, a good education and good wealth, and if he is nonetheless not proud of his opulences, it is to be understood that he is especially favored by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Purport. When in spite of possessing all these opulences, a person is not proud, this means that he is fully aware that all his opulences are due to the mercy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He therefore engages all his possessions in the service of the Lord. A devotee knows very well that everything, even his body, belongs to the Supreme Lord. If one lives perfectly in such Krishna consciousness, it is to be understood that he is especially favored by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The conclusion is that once being deprived of his wealth is not to be considered the special mercy of the Lord. If one continues in his opulent position but does not become unnecessarily proud, falsely thinking that he is the proprietor of everything, this is the Lord's special mercy. Hare Krishna. So we are reading this Bali Maharaj surrenders his life. Now Lord is speaking to Brahmaji, Vindhyavali, the wife of Bali Maharaj, and others who are present there. In fact, Bali Maharaj himself. When Lord starts speaking, you know all the story. He starts speaking in verse number 24. He is saying that, O Brahma, intoxicated by wealth, a person becomes arrogant. Thus he has no respect for anyone within the three worlds, not even for me. To such a person, I show special favor by taking away all his possessions. The famous verse we know that, Yasyaham anugrunami hanisyami tadhani sani. So Lord takes everything, the possessions, the person or the devotee possess, to give him the special mercy. So he is saying, this dhana, the wealth, is considered as visa, poison. Visa means wealth. So how can taking away wealth be mercy? Because by wealth a person becomes proud. So this he explains in express in 24 number verse. Then Lord says, the rarity of human form. Lord says that while rotating in the cycle of birth and death again and again in different species, because of his karma, the dependent living entity by good fortune may happen to become a human being. By good fortune, it's not so easy to get this human form. Someone said a story, some Puranic story, that once Narad Muni asked to Lord Vishnu What is the power of association, sadhu sangha? And Lord said that go to that place, particular place, and see that worm. And the Narad Muni went and saw that worm. Worm was there in gutter. And he saw that worm and he asked, what is the power of association? And then worm died. Immediately, after hearing the question, the worm dead. He was surprised. And then he came back to Lord. Lord, did you get your answer? And Narad Muni said, no. He said that go to another place. Then he sent him to another place. And he went there, was a beautiful butterfly. And he went there and he asked the same question to the butterfly. What is the power of this sadhu sangha? And butterfly also died. Just immediately after hearing the question. And he was all the more surprised. And he again went back to the Lord. Lord asked, did you get your answer? He said, no, after asking the question, any person, the entity, he, Ram Naam Satya Hai, he leaves his body. And then he said that, no, now you go to the king. And the king has got a son. After years of waiting, he got a son. And Narad Muni became scared. What if the same thing repeats? What happened with worm and then butterfly? If same thing repeats, and Narad Muni said, then, no, I will not take the risk. I will not go to this prince, newly born prince. Then what will happen to him? And then king will punish me. He said, no, have faith on me and just go. And then Narad Muni went, putting faith on Lord. And he went to the king, and king welcomed him. And just like Nand ke Anand Vayo Jai Kaniya Lal ki, we sing. So there was a celebration that the king has begot a son after many years. So when he saw Narad Muni, and Narad Muni was a saintly person, he thought that let take the Narad Muni, and Narad Muni will give blessing to my child. And Narad Muni with a heavy heart, you can imagine. Previous cases, he went and he saw that child and he asked the same question. Can I ask a question like that? Because previous thing had happened. Then they asked to the child that, what is the power of association? What is the power of sadhu sangha? And the newly born child started speaking. Oh, Narad Muni, do you remember you once asked the same question to a worm? I was elevated. I was that same entity. And do you remember that you asked the same question to a butterfly? I was also the same entity. Like it's called spiritual evolution, transmigration. And the worm became butterfly. And now, I am a prince. I have taken birth in an aristocrat family, the son of king. And then, this is the power, what you are asking the question, what is the power of association? This is the power that I was a worm in a stool or gutter. I became a butterfly, and then now I became a prince, and now by your association I am a devotee. So this such is rare of human birth. Can you imagine? 84 lakh species who have wandered, all varieties of 9 lakh aquatics and everything. At last we got this human form, and that too, to become a devotee, it's all the more rare. And that to come to the spiritual world, holy land of Sri Vrindavan Dham. See, what piety we must have done in our previous life that we have got this opportunity here. So this Lord is saying that human birth is very rare. So he is saying that my mercy is hard to understand. Actually, this M-E-R-C-Y is only five letters. And it's very difficult to understand. The same word, mercy, you see different expressions by different people. Like some say, oh, this is the mercy of Lord. And some others say, is this the mercy? This is the called mercy? You see the expressions? The same mercy is very hard to understand. It's only five letter word. And completely different scenario, different situations. And Lord is saying that Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur comments that my mercy is hard for people to understand and of various types. Hear about the characteristics of my mercy. Wandering about in various bodies such as worms and insects. At last one gets the human form. That is nothing but my mercy. And today's verse, Lord is saying, that generally we hear that one who is having these four qualities, opulences, he 99% chance he doesn't become devotee. Janma Isharya Sutta Sribi Edo Maman Idam Puman, Kunti says, Kunti Maharani says. I said 99%, we have experience of this. High worth, opulence, wealth, and knowledgeable, very learned, and beauty, very handsome or beautiful. You see, how many people become devotee? How many millionaires and billionaires and the Microsoft CEO and the Ambanis become the 16th round of chanting devotee? How many? And how many of these movie stars and actor and actress become Hare Krishna? Hardly. Practically less. How many IITians and how many the learned scholars from the Banaras become a Hare Krishna monk? Very few. There are many, devotees, Radhishyam Prabhu from Pune and Gaurang Prabhu from Mumbai, and there are very some devotees in Mumbai and Pune, they are IITians, but still they are staunch devotee. So generally one doesn't become devotee. This is the verdict of Srimad Bhagavatam. And the proof is Kunti Maharani says. Even after one has taken birth in high Mishra or Upadhyaya or Tripathi or Chaturvedi Brahmana family, and that person is really handsome, beautiful, looks, and then he is well versed in Shastra and he is very linguistic, he can speak English, Hindi, Sanskrit and many languages. Like this, all the opulences, and also he is a devotee. You can do a Google search. Very difficult to find that such a person, if he is a totally staunch devotee. Therefore, in that situation, if someone is devotee, then Lord says today's word that this is my special mercy on that person. Otherwise, it is very difficult, hard to become a devotee. So, Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad says, the reason is that because a person, because of these opulences, one becomes proud. Garva, stambha, ahamkara. Therefore, the pride becomes the impediment or hindrance to surrender to the Lord. And here, that is my mercy. That this is a different type of mercy. I said, no, it's very difficult to understand mercy. This kripa, this mercy word is very popular, most wanted, and everyone knows, especially in devotional line. Prabhu, oh Lord, please give us mercy. Do you want mercy? What kind of mercy you want? So previously, in the beginning of the prayer, slokas, Lord is saying, my mercy is I take away everything, I snatch everything. This is mercy. And now he is saying that my mercy is I give everything. I give everything, but still the devotee is not shaken or is not getting disturbed. And Prabhupada writes in the purport, in the next verse, the same theme continues in tomorrow's verse also. He says that there are many cases like Dhruva Maharaj, Prahlad Maharaj, Ambarish Maharaj, Maharaj Parikshit, Yudhishthir Maharaj, and then so many. In today's in Kali Yuga, there are our six Goswamis, Rupa and Sanatan. Do you know the annual income of Raghunath Das Goswami? 12 lakh gold coin. One gold coin is very difficult to see nowadays. They say that we have seen only TV, serial or cinema, that gold biscuit. Not Britannia Ampro biscuit, but gold biscuit. Only in some movie or TV. 12 lakh gold coins. Annual income means monthly 1 lakh gold coin. How much GST he would have given, just imagine. 1 lakh gold coin he was having, such an income. And Das Goswami was extremely beautiful, rich. His wife was like Apsara. Everything was... Don't think that Das Goswami's parents were non-devotee. If you read Chaitanya Charitamrita, just 2 days back we heard, this is past time, Chida Dahi Mahotsav, Das Goswami's parents were, my dear devotees, they were pakka devotee. Generally the congregation, they have their child, the child also becomes devotee. But hardly any congregation will say that, I just want to give my son to become full-time devotee in ISKCON Brahmachari Ashram. Very rare to see. So Das Goswami's parents were also pakka devotee of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So what was difficulty for Das Goswami to practice spirituality in remaining in house? There may be, could have many justification. My parents were 16 rounder initiated devotee. We have deities in our Lord. My guru is Balabhadra Bhattacharya, my spiritual teacher, preacher. And there is no scarcity. My wife is also very surrendered devotee. But still, Mahaprabhu's mercy was totally different. If he wants someone, then he gives the special mercy. And Das Goswami went to Puri to surrender to the Lord. So this mercy is very difficult to understand. Therefore, he is saying here that previously they mentioned mercy taking away wealth. But I do not take away his wealth since there is no harm in his possessing at that wealth. Generally, people have this mentality that if you worship Lord Hari, he steals Hari. And he takes away everything. But not in every case. Lord is saying that I don't take that opulence or that possession if that doesn't become hindrance or impediment in the path of that devotional devotee. I don't take. I give all opulences. Then only people can have faith. My Guru Maharaj would say that if everyone will think that is a very, what kind of strange Lord is that if someone surrenders and Lord takes everything, then who will become a devotee of Lord? So therefore Lord gives, like he gave to Dhruva Maharaj, he gave to Sudama, he gave to many persons. Lord gave mercy to Srutadev and Bahulasa, and both are completely opposite. Do you know the story? Srutadev was poor Brahmana and Bahulas was a king of Mithila. And Lord gave similar type of mercy to both. And they both were happy because the contentment was there, the satisfaction was there. So both are happy in any kind of situation. So generally, who comes to the lotus feet of the Lord? Krishna says in Gita, Arto Arthati Jigyasu Jnani. Right? But in today's day and age, aaj ke tarikh mein agar kahenge, who comes to the lotus feet of the Lord? Those who are really artha and maha artha and super artha and double super artha. Those who are really frustrated, disgusted, hatas and totally good for nothing for the world, they say, hardly anyone who are jigyasu and jnani, anyone comes to the lotus feet of the Lord. We can see in our life also, what kind of reverse, what kind of challenges and such situation comes that, oh Lord, at last we come to you, and then we come. And we see, we have experienced that, see this mercy factor, how it works, that in some cases, before becoming devotee, they were in very much well standard and good standard in wealthy condition. And after becoming devotee, it becomes completely different, opposite. And in other cases, person was a simple, normal, lower middle class family. After becoming Krishna consciousness, his business become doubled. We have experience of both kinds of people. He was a simple, he had a simple shop, like this panwala or whatever, or some simple. There is one devotee in Pune, I see. After he became initiated by Loknath Swami Maharaj, and he is a devotee now, and he has now 2-3 shops, and he is the multi-millionaire now, rich person. Wow, bhakti ka kya kamal hai. What is the result of practicing bhakti? And Mahaprabhu says, when Prakashananda Saraswati asked that, Piva mantra dila gosai kiva tar bol, japite japite mon hoila pagol. What kind of mantra you gave that I became mad? The same payar for such kind of persons. They say that, Prabhu, kiva mantra dila Prabhu kiva tar bol, japite japite business hoilo double. When I chant Hare Krishna, my business become double. The reason is that at that moment only all the suitable plans comes when I start chanting. Because to make business double, you need some concrete plan. And do you know what time the plan comes exactly? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram. And that time all varieties of plan comes. And that's why he becomes millionaire. And in some cases, they are well established and they are very nice and all opulences are there. But when someone becomes devotee or he joins in ashram, my God, what kind of disaster happens? His parents becomes poverty stricken. His father loses his job. His mother admits in the hospital. And his brother is left home. His sister is not able to get married. And everything, all disaster comes. And such varieties of experiences. Is this the mercy? Vrindavan Viharipo says, yes. Is this the mercy? So, difficult to understand, Lord himself that, difficult to understand the mercy. And in any kind of situation, either reverse or the opposite, if the person still continues the practice of Krishna consciousness, having faith on the Lord that Lord does all good to me in any kind of situation, that person becomes a suitable candidate for the liberation. famous verse, Lord Brahma says, Tattena Kampasu Samiksamana. So what is the secret, what is the formula that we can be fixed up in any kind of situation, either reverse or opposite, in favorable situation? In tomorrow's verse, in purport, Prabhupada writes one sentence, which I really like it, I would like to read it. When a devotee, please listen carefully, is fixed in his devotional service, there is no need for the Lord to deprive him from his material opulences. When a devotee is fixed in his devotional service, Lord doesn't take the opulences. Further he says, the Supreme Personality of Godhead never takes away material opulences achieved because of devotional service. Although he sometimes takes away opulences achieved by pious activities. You know, why someone becomes a wealthy or high parentage or learned or beauty? Because of the pious deeds, pious piety, past karma. So that Lord may takes. But sometime after becoming devotee, if someone gets, it's not necessary that Lord will take it. And that is actually the symptom of a characteristic of pure devotion, subhada. You know this word subhada? Sixth characteristic of devotion, pure uttama bhakti, subhada. All auspiciousness. You start practicing Krishna consciousness, all auspiciousness will come. All mangal, bhavan, everything all will be mangal, subhada. And sometime there is also by practicing bhakti, everything becomes favorable, wealth, the wife is submissive, and children are also submissive, and the opulences are there, and the wealth is there, everything is there. That also one of the reason that bhakti utha anartha. Madhurya Kadambini, Vishwanatha Chakravarti Pad writes, by practicing bhakti, one gets all siddhis. By practicing, one may get wealth, one may get post position and prestige. But that, my dear devotee, we should carefully understand that is not the end result of bhakti. That is anusangik, a side product, side result. The primary result of practicing bhakti is that we will get Suddha Bhakti, Krishna Prema. But these are all side products. We may get, but we should not get carried away. But it has the effect, one gets carried away. Just imagine that simple king was very wonderful king ruling the kingdom in the earthly planet known as Nahus. You know that Nahus? Once he became Indra, and just see what happened. You know that story. He became Sarpa. Ajgar. So this is the danger, risk in these opulences. So therefore he says that sometime he takes away opulences achieved by pious activities. He does this to make a devotee prideless or put him in a better position in devotional service. And Lord gives a wonderful description is there in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Leela. Just a minute. Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Leela, chapter 7, text 127. So he says, when Mahaprabhu was in South India trip, and he met Kurma Brahmana, also Vasudev Vipra. Now this is the practical, you know, some practical plan of action should be there. How we can not get carried away in opulences, in favorable situation or in reverse situation. So the sutra is Mahaprabhu saying, Prabhu kahe aichhe bata kabhu na kahiva, grihe rahi Krishna nama nirantara laiva. He is saying to Kurma Brahmana. Kurma Brahmana wanted to give up the home and to travel with Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu said, don't speak like that again. Better to remain at home and chant the holy name of Krishna always. Jar dekho tare kaha Krishna upadesh amar agyaya guru hoya tarai desh. Instruct everyone to follow the orders of Lord Sri Krishna. They are given in the Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. In this way, become a spiritual master and try to liberate everyone in this land. So he didn't allow Kurma Brahmana to come with him. He said, better you stay Stane Sthita Sutikatam and chant Hare Krishna and preach this message. And if he says that, oh my God, now if I have got your mercy, I may get carried away by this current. How I can become undisturbed? Mahaprabhu is saying, kabhuna badhibe tomar vishaya taranga punarapi ethane pabe mora sanga. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu further advised the Brahmana Kurma, if you follow this instruction, your materialistic life at home will not obstruct your spiritual advancement. The even remaining in family life, you can advance in spiritual life. Indeed, if you follow the regulative principle, we will again meet here. And rather, you will never lose my company. And in the same way, ahead he says to Vasudev Vipra, you know that Vasudev Vipra, when he heard that Mahaprabhu had come, he wanted to see him and he came to Kurma Brahmana. Kurma Brahmana said, he left. Mahaprabhu chale gaye. And he was completely devastated. And he was crying and praying to the Lord Chaitanya in the heart that I couldn't see you. And Lord came back again. And he embraced him, as you know that he was a leprosy. And he became totally a handsome, like Gandharva. All the disease, all the worms and the leprosy he was having in the body, everything gets clear. And this was the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. Can you imagine this? So just by one embrace, Vasudev Vipra got cured. And do you remember in the past times of Sanatana Goswami, when he was also having the wounds in his body, and Lord was embracing him again and again. He was not getting cured. Do you know this? He was not getting cured. He was with Haridas Thakur. Here we see at once Vasudev Vipra got cured. And Sanatana Goswami, who was the eternal associate of Lord Chaitanya, he was having some wound in his body. And pus was coming from his body. And Lord Chaitanya would embrace him in Puri. And it's not that immediately Sanatana Goswami got to. Is this the mercy? Now you can ask. And that was the mercy, and this is also what kind of mercy is this? It's very difficult to understand. So here he says, Prabhu sparse dukha sange kushtha dure gela anande sahita anga sundara hoila. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu touched him, both the leprosy and his distress went to a distant place. Indeed, Vasudev body became a very beautiful to his great happiness. And then he says, Prabhu kahe kabhu tomar na hoibe abhiman nirantara kaha tumi Krishna Krishna naam. To protect the Brahmana, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu advised him to chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, incessantly. I was telling you in the beginning that what was that secret, that formula, that we will not become proud in any situation, we will not get carried away, we will not become disturbed, we will become unshakable. So this is saying that chant Hare Krishna mantra incessantly. You know, incessantly, nirantara. By doing so, you will never become unnecessarily proud. Krishna upadeshi kara jivera nistar achirate Krishna toma karibe nangikar. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also advised Vasudev to preach about Krishna and thus liberate living entities. As a result, Krishna would very soon accept him as a devotee. So the mood, Mahaprabhu says, is every day we recite in the early morning, Trinandapi Sunichena Tarorapi Sahisruna Amanina Manadena Kirtaniyasa. In this mood, if we continuously chant Hare Krishna, then we will be free from all impurities. We will get rid from all impurities. We will not become proud. At the same time, today we will discuss little bit about Lord Jagannath. Today is Jyeshtha Purnima. So, this is also called Devasnan Purnima. Devasnan Purnima is the day in the beginning of this yuga, this millennium, in Swayambhuva Manvantar, when Maharaj Indradumna first established Lord Jagannath in the altar, he did Abhishek. Just like in our DT installation ceremony, you must have seen, we do Abhishek. So in the same way, Maharaj Indradumna did Abhishek of Jagannath, Baldev, Subhadra and Sudarshan on this day. So therefore, this is called Appearance Day of Lord Jagannath. We say, Happy Birthday to... So Happy Birthday to Lord Jagannath. Sri Jagannath Mahaprabhu ki. So, to commemorate that, celebrate every year, in Puri, Lord comes out of his altar and there is a Snana Mandapa. How many of you have gone to Puri? Please raise your hand. Very nice. If you have not gone, please do visit. So Jagannath Puri, and there is a Snana Mandapa near Anand Bazar. Very huge place, because everything is Bada. In Orissa they call, in Odia they call Bada Danda, Bada Thakura, Bada Bhoga, Bada Mahaprasa, everything is Bada. Bada means big. So that Mandap is also very big. So today there you can see live on internet that or TV that how Lord Jagannath, Baldev, Subhadra, Sudarshan, they come. One day before, there is a special well, kuwa, called Sona Kuwa. Sona means gold and kuwa means well. Golden well. It's not made of gold. There is a reason behind this. When Maharaj Chodaganga Dev was the king of Odisha, who built the present Jagannath temple, what we see today. Previously it was completely like, you know. So he renovated, he made a new temple. It was broken before. Some 1,000 years back, King Chodaganga Dev, when Gangavans was ruling in the Odisha, King Chodaganga Dev thought that I should rebuild this temple for Lord Jagannath. But for to build the temple, we require wealth. How to get the wealth? He conquered all the neighbor kingdom. And he got so many wealth, so much wealth, like jewelries and all varieties of golds and wealth, and he poured in that well. So that well become filled with gold and all kinds of wealth. Therefore that is called Sona Kuwa, golden well. So in that particular, and by that wealth he built that Jagannath Mandir, what we presently see. So in that, from that wealth, they take the water. Throughout the year they don't use the water for Jagannath. Only on this day, the day before, means yesterday, Chaturdashi, the Pandas, actually not the Pandas, you can say the Daitas, you know, Daita means the descendants of Sabara, Vishwavasu. Vishwavasu, right? And the Lalita's son, the Lalita, the wife of that, the Brahmana, Vidyapati, they are called Suwaras. So this Daitas, Daitapati and Suwaras, worship will start from today, till the Lord will return to the Jagannath temple. So they collect the water, they say 108 kalas, the 108 pots, that made of gold and or bronze or many So 108 pots, they collect the water from that well. Throughout the year that well is unused, but yesterday the well, they clean the well and the well becomes filled with the celestial water. And then they recite the Vedic hymns, the mantras, and there's Aguru, Chandan, and many such kind of powerful things, celestial things they put. And they preserve that on the day before with invoking the mantras. And 33 for Jagannath, or 32, or 30 for Baldev, and 28 kalas for Subhadra, and 14 kalas for Sudarshan. And also the Utsava Murti of Jagannath is called Madan Mohan. He will be also there during Snana Yatra. So like this they collect. And today, this morning, the Lord comes come out from the altar. That's called Pandi Vijay, you know, Pandu Vijay. And they say Pahandi. Pahandi means in a line, Lord comes with a procession. You have seen in the TV how the Lord comes during Rath Yatra. So there are various Pahandis, Goti Pahandi and Dhadi Pahandi. So Goti Pahandi means Baldev comes and Subhadra comes during Rath Yatra. And today is Dhadi Pahandi. Dhadi Pahandi means in the line, in a straight line, Lord comes from the altar. Jagannath, Baldev, Subhadra and Sudarshan with Madan Mohan. The Utsav deity of Lord Jagannath. But Lord Jagannath doesn't go anywhere and everywhere. Utsav Murti goes. But today, the whole set of Lord, the whole family you can say, they come out. And then the Snana Yatra takes place. Water, with Abhimantrit water, and they pour the water on the Lord's body, and everyone can see. And today the audience can stand on the grand road, and then they allow also to go in front of there is a barricade. You can see today in the TV that they move, that is moving crowd, just like we do in our Abhishek, sometimes the moving crowd. So they also, the crowd also goes by seeing the beautiful form of Lord Jagannath. It is said that Dole tu Dolo Govinda, Chape tu Madhusudana, Rathe tu Bamanam Drushta, Punarjanma na Vidyate. If someone sees Dolo Yatra during Phalgun, Gaur Purnima, and if someone sees Chandani Yatra, just few days back it went in Narendra Sarovar, Chape tu Madhusudana, and if someone sees Lord in Kath, either in Rath Yatra or especially the Sona base, golden decoration during Asad Ekadasi, Dev Sain Ekadasi, one who sees Lord Jagannath decorated with golden ornaments in the Kath, that person says this life is the last life. And huge crowd goes. So in the same way, Snana Yatra, in Snana Mandapa, Bathing Ghat, and Rath Yatra, Car Festival, and Sona Base, golden decoration, golden incarnation, golden decoration in the car, if someone sees, is the verdict of the Shastra that this is his last life. So this is today the most auspicious Snana Yatra. And then Lord does a special pastime of becoming sick, getting sick. Just like if someone takes so much bath, he becomes sick. So Lord does this Naralila, the human-like pastime, and for another 15-20 days, he becomes sick, and no one can take darshan of Lord. Devotees go to Alarnath. So there was one devotee called Ganapati Bhatt from South India. He was a Brahmin. He came to Odisha. And the king of Odisha welcomed him. And he was a very learned scholar. And he pleased the king by his scholarly presentation. And he said that I wanted to, and the Lord, the king invited him, that devotee. Do you want to see our worshipable Lord? I said, okay, why not? I just want to see your Lord. But when he saw the Lord, there was no hand, no leg, round eye, with no eyelids, nothing. What kind of Lord, strange Lord is this? Then my Lord is so beautiful. Ganapati Bappa Moriya. My Lord is wonderful, so beautiful. He is having all forms. And this, what kind of strange Lord is that? He doesn't have any limbs in his body. And he was not so much interested. So there are various versions of the story. But then Lord understood. And some say that Lord came in the dream of Pujari, and also Lord came in the dream of king. And he said that, today I want to be decorated like elephant. So because to give faith to that devotee known as Ganapati Bhatta, who was a very learned scholar, Brahman devotee. And when the devotee came on this day, to see the Snana yatra mahotsav, the bathing ceremony. After bathing ceremony, the Lord was decorated with elephant. That's called Gaja Vesa. Gaja means elephant. Vesa means decorated. So elephant decoration today. You will see, you can see in the our ISKCON deities also, or even Puri, main Jagannath, the Lord will be decorated. Jagannath, Baldev, Subhadra will be decorated as elephant. Another reason also they say, because Lord will be taking bath, so much water, all his beautiful face will be washed away, the paintings will be washed away. So, to not to show the face, they sometimes cover the body with the elephant, so that only eyes can be seen. And Lord will not show his that face which is totally washed away by the bathing, the paintings will be washed away. And for another 15-20 days, when Lord will be in Anavasara, Lord will be repainted again. That's called, of course it is his pastime, this fever pastime. At the same time, they decorate the Lord, Jagannath, Baldev, Subhadra, Sudarshan. So today is most auspicious day, Snana Yatra. We have our festival in Jagannath Mandir, yes. So you can attend the festival and pray to the Lord. Because today will be the last darshan of Jagannath ji. And then we will get to see on Navayovan base just before Rath Yatra. And you can see the through the special arrangement of social media. Also you can see the live darshan of directly from Puri and take the blessings. Hare Krishna. Shri Jagannath Baldev Subhadra Sudarshan ki. Shri Snana Yatra Mahotsav ki. Patita Pavan Shri Jagannath Bhagavan ki. Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki. Nitai Gaur Premanande. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much.